That's a coleoid, I think. Little swine. Not even a bloody big one, look. Oh no, it's a decent pot, decent collie. How the fuck am I going to get that up now? They look like in the tide, Dad. I said they feel a bit heavy when they're down tide. All that way and it let go here. Oh. Well, no, it didn't let go. They rip out, don't they? Catching in the same place, you know. Yeah, there must be on, there must be a rock or something there. I'm casting straight out into the bay, going, you know what, 70, 80 yards. Drifting round, getting it in there. This is, none of this hugging the bloody weed or nothing. He's like a lump, it might be a pollock, this one, not fighting like a coalie. He's not fighting like a coalie at the moment. Well, look, the thing is, they're not big fish, are they? So when they're not fighting because they're in clean ground, they don't feel like much. And then they see a rock. Yeah, yeah, and then you think you've got a bloody oodsing on. There's some cracking head shakes. Oh, he's half decent pollock. That's just like me. Oh, see, look, that. No, hold on. They hit like a bloody train, they do. For a fish that will probably, if I land it, will probably be 2.5-3 pounds. If that. No. Yeah. Yeah. This is probably one of the few that's actually hooked through the snout. Or probably a mat. Oh, it is a coalie. Oh. They're very tuna-esque head shakes, you know. Yeah. Not really, I don't think. Is he?
High water, right? fish.
Now, pollock actually.
Not a bumpkin, is it?
No,
not coal, not a coaly clump.
Ah, no, I think it's in the side, because that was a. No, but... Trouble is, the coaly fights so hard.
Yeah, you don't know if you've got a bloody 1 pounder or a 4 pounder. Yeah.
Somebody goes in the rock and then the other one. Yeah, I don't know why, sometimes when they do, again, you watch them roll.
You see it now, can you?
No, no, not with glasses on. But they seem to swim out.
Yeah.